Nothing's changed. Nothing's gonna be the same again.
Nothing to see here.
Welcome to Through the Anomaly.
Hi.
Hey.
Hello. Woo! If you saw the making laugh, I'm out of breath. Showing.
If you saw the behind the scenes last year, you might have learned a little bit on what goes into making Primeval.
What am I saying?
I'm here to show you a little bit more.
It's like being a kid. It's like getting to be a kid but with the proper toys. You don't actually have to kind of imagine too much. It's actually all there for you. You get all the stuff that you wanted to have as a kid but you didn't get. And you actually have it now on this show.
The award for one of the coolest things in the show this year goes to... The Ark.
Anomaly. Research. Center. Now, the person responsible for creating this masterpiece is our very own production designer. So, Paul, what was the first thing you saw?
I saw this building here in Kinetic, and I thought it's such an amazing building that it ought to be used for shooting in. The best thing to do was cover up the windows, because that's the reason no one else has shot in here, and make it look as though it's been sunk into the ground. And that way we could use the whole building. Grade 2 listed building, and it used to be used for testing tank lasers. It's one of the most amazing structures I've seen.
The biggest rush I got was the first day that we walked into the Ark. You know, there's quite a big budget on this show, but you're never quite sure as to what it can extend to.
We've got the wall drawn up, which is the most expensive part of it, of the build, then the ramp drawn up, and then Lester's and Leek's office on the top. And then we had a costing to knock down the walls, down the corridor, in order to make an area for the team to relax and to go to the gym and to cook and eat, and an armory down there as well.
And when I walked in and saw this place, I just thought it was tremendous. They really must believe that we're doing something right in order to build this thing, because this thing's proper.
60 foot across this way, 70 foot of ramp.
It was like walking onto a real proper kind of film set. And it just felt like, a really kind of great validation of the series and the work that everybody had done on it.
It occurred to us that this year it would be more interesting to get a kind of personal insight of behind the scenes, almost like a personal journal for the show. Last year there was a kind of slightly dry, straightforward, traditional documentary, whereas this time we thought, I don't know, who could we give the camera to this time who could get us behind the scenes, get us access to things? When we couldn't get him, we got you.
Now, obviously, with Primeval Series 2, there's loads more action sequences. Stunts everywhere. Ow! Explosions. Like, way more important than that.
Connor gets a gun. Yeah?
Shoot it, Connor!
It's fine, I've got it. Obviously, some people are better at action than others.
Like a cat, let's see how it should be done.
This is Hannah Spirit on the set of Primeval, end of block 1, learning to fly. excited, but we don't have that much time, so all I can do is my best.
Probably one of the hardest kicks to do. It's very complicated to do it off the ground. You have to be like a really good martial artist to do it that way. So we cheat a little bit, and it's film, so we can do what we want, basically.
So now what we're trying to do is recreate the lighting to match that shot and the exact angle that the camera was at when she was on the plinth. And what we've got is a green screen where we'll be able to drop in the background that we shot those weeks ago. If we get the angle exactly right, no one will know. Bit of magic.
What we're going to do is we're going to hang Hannah on the wires. The harness will fit round Hannah here. It's like a seat harness, and she'll be tied into that.
Come on, and jump. Yeah. Good. Three, two, one, action, jump. Yeah, good. That's it.
Definitely look great, yeah, and especially with, when Hannah, because she's quite supple and she's done a bit of dancing as well, with a nice suppleness and the speed of her kick, it should look lovely.
What's that?
We've got a really powerful kick.
Yeah.
Brilliant. High five.
When we were looking at developing characters into the second series, we had some characters that, you know, the main cast that we knew the audience loved. We'd had a great response to them, and obviously we wanted to take them further. So we've given all our key cast different kinds of storylines this time. Obviously Cutter still has a thing going with Helen. There's all kinds of different things happening for the main characters. We also wanted to introduce some new characters, because all shows need to be kept fresh, need to be have different things happening in them. So we brought in some new characters as well, because the key with a show like this is you have to constantly keep reinventing it. As soon as the audience gets ahead of you in terms of what they think is going to happen, and if they're right, the show becomes less compelling. So we had to make sure that we gave people what they loved, but also kept it fresh.
And sure, you know, we don't just turn up every day and laugh gaily all the way through the day, but as a premise, it's a kind of perfect job, really. From time to time, I find other people's unprofessionalism a little testing. Yeah.
Any names?
Well, I think you know who I'm talking about.
Anomalies.
How is the process of making the second series of Primeval going for you? Are you enjoying yourself? Is it all very much fun and glamorous?
It is going exceedingly well.
Yeah.
Yes.
Are you very excited?
About what?
About just all the fun and games that we have when we're doing this particular
excited,
series.
Excited, but nervous at the same time.
Ah.
Yeah.
I see.
Yeah.
Not as easy as it looks, you know.
Come in and watch me take it off.
What's the difficulties of wearing a wetsuit, Dougie?
Having a pee.
Jim, you look a bit nervous about this next step.
Yeah, well, last time I did it back in 86, I dislocated both shoulders and hips, but it was worth it.